Honey, allow me to be your sign that you have been asking for and been needing to let go of that situation that has been doing nothing but causing you stress and anxiety, honey. It is not worth it for it to be living in your mind rent-free and you're not being paid for it, honey. Hey, girl. Hello, my beautiful Capricorn. How are you doing? My name is Simply Velka, and today we're going to be doing your bonus weekly tarot reading today. So if you find any tarot cards that resonate with you in this weekly reading, be sure to let me know in the comments below which tarot cards do, how they do, right? Also, be sure to give this video a like and subscribe if you do enjoy this reading, or you just enjoy my vibe, Capricorn, right? Because it does help out my tarot channel a lot, and I'm super appreciative when you do that. And then also, Capricorn, I do your weekly tarot reading for your zodiac sign, obviously, Capricorn, which goes more in depth, which I'll leave a link to somewhere around here for you to check out at a later point if you would like. But when it comes to any of my tarot readings, be sure to rely on your intuition, Capricorn, because put it in perspective, I'm just a tarot man. Technically, I guess so I am. I'm just a man reading some tarot cards to you, Capricorn. You know your situation better than I ever possibly could, so take the tarot cards that resonate and leave what doesn't, because I promise you I'm not going to be offended by it whatsoever. I believe my tarot cards, my tarot readings are here just to give you some food for thought, a perspective for you to consider, but never making the decision in your life, because it's your life to live, not mine, and not these tarot cards, Capricorn. But with all that being said, let's just get into your reading for today, Capricorn. Hello, my beautiful Capricorn. So let's just get started with your tarot reading. I like to take your readings, everyone's readings actually, into sections. So I know you saw the cards, Capricorn, but let me show you the ones we're going to start addressing first. We have your Ace of Wands, your Three of Swords, honey. I just had a moment. Your Queen of Pentacles and the Tower card, which I feel like we might start with the Tower card, Capricorn, for you. Because I feel like it kind of goes with the Three of Swords, don't you think? You guys, I feel like it's extremely recent, right? I feel like this definitely makes sense as to, you guys are probably part of the reason why I was even inspired to do the bonus messages this week for the zodiac signs, to be honest, Capricorn, because y'all's reading so far has been like the one where it feels like something just really recently happened that really took the wind out of you, that really brought forth a lot of pain, or just at the very least a lot of disappointment with something crumbling down. It's a situation that really I just keep on feeling like just like this really extreme heaviness, right? Feels even like for some of you Capricorns, like even while you're receiving this reading, you're still in the process of processing that situation. And oh, it's crazy, just to see, yeah, Nine of Swords comes out, Capricorn. Yeah, this is whatever the situation was for you, Capricorn. It brought forth a lot of anxiety, brought forth a lot of pain. Maybe even in this situation, for some of you Capricorns, this like this whole crumbling, the process of this crumbling, it probably was a progressive thing, and just like extremely recent, right? Maybe like the last like week, like the final wrecking ball. How many times can I say like? The final wrecking ball for you, Capricorn, of taking this down just recently happened. But it was like during this time that it just gave you a lot of anxiety. Two of Pentacles, you didn't really know what to do with the situation, Capricorn. Right, you're weighing things out in the middle of this chaos, being like, what should I do? How do I even handle this situation, Capricorn, right? But here's the thing, like through all this, right, you got all this heaviness, you got all this pain, and it's almost like this has caused you, Capricorn, to just start finally putting yourself first. I feel like in this situation here, once like whatever happened for you, Capricorn, I feel like now you're in this place of the Ace of Wands and the Queen of Coins, where you're just like, all right, well, kind of realize now I only have myself to rely on in this life. And so now you're kind of, can't help but feel like you're now starting to travel your path just by yourself for a while. It does feel like even if there's like no one even directly involved in like that Tower moment and that Three of Swords moment, Capricorn, for you, it does just, I do just get this feeling like you just don't want to deal with people right now. Like, you don't want to be around anyone. You just kind of want to be by yourself. Yeah, let me see here. Yeah, you want to be by yourself, Capricorn. And let's see here. The Hanged Man. Yeah, it feels like you just see things differently. I don't know. The only thing I am going to say, Capricorn, with all this heavy energy, I wouldn't be a proper friend to y'all, right? If I didn't say, I am a little bit worried about some of you Capricorns, because it feels like for this sense here, it feels like some of you guys have kind of like lost hope in the world. Like, it's kind of like some of you guys have kind of like lost faith in humanity, or just feel as if like this whole, like, I don't know. I can't help but feel like for some of you guys are not enjoying this life anymore. And that sounds super depressing. I don't mean it in like a depressing way. That's probably even why some of you Capricorns feel like you're in just like this sense of just like, you don't even want to deal with anybody anymore. Just because it's just like, you're just tired. Like, and I get it, right? It's not like, I don't think it's like a sense of where it's like, it just feels like you're just tired of having to try so hard with things. And so now, rather than giving out your energy to things, you're just tending to yourself now. And so let's get into the second section of your tarot cards, Capricorn. You have your Emperor card with the Knight of Wands. This has been popping up for everybody in all my tarot decks, Capricorn. It's crazy. The Ace of Wands following you, and the Emperor, or the Hierophant rather, not the Emperor. So, but you did get the Emperor, so I guess I want to start with the Emperor, because I feel like this is still, like, all the cards that you're getting, Capricorn, they're all, like, very, like, reclusive, answering to no one else, like, it's kind of just, like, you, yourself, sort of energy. It definitely feels like you're claiming the second part of your journey just to be by yourself. I don't know, like... And I normally would be kind of hesitant to be like pushing this narrative of like just being alone, especially when like with such a heavy message, because I feel like a lot of people just would be like more bummed out about hearing it. But I kind of get the sense for some of you Capricorns, there's like a sense of comfort and like getting this affirmation that this is like the best thing for you to do right now, is where it's like not really involving other energies here, right? With this Nine of Wands, this is the card that I say is like where it's like you take a road trip to the Grand Canyon or to Vegas without telling anybody, and it's just like you and your own journey, right? With the Ace of Wands and the Hierophant, this is all about in the search for like knowledge and the search of like trying to, well, what are you trying to do? Like, why are you going on this journey, I guess, right? Because I was saying before, Capricorn, I just want to make sure that you don't feel too cynical about life or give up hope on like there being like good, right? Don't give up on humanity. Don't give up on this game, or this board game that we call life, Capricorn. Don't give up, right? Don't lose faith. But I want to see real quick where it is that you're, this journey that you're going on, Capricorn. Six of Swords, Nine of Pentacles, and then the Seven of Pentacles. It's almost like for you Capricorns, you want to find something that... It's like you're in the search for finding something that gives you more independence, or in the search of finding like your thing, whatever that thing is for you. And I don't even think you could even define like your thing. And I feel like that's part of the process as to why you don't want to be around anybody again, Capricorn, is because it's like some of you guys are trying, like you're searching for your purpose, searching for like why it is that you're even here anymore. Not anymore, but like, yeah, you're just trying to find more meaning to things. You're trying to no longer like try to like work in a like a group setting, right? It feels like your situation before, like you did this, try to do this final group project with people and like didn't work out, Capricorn, and now you're just like, you know what, I'm done trying to make it work with other people. I'm just going to put all my energy into myself now, since no one ever appreciates it, right? Or it just goes underappreciated. And Now it just kind of feels like you're putting yourself first and really just starting like this next phase of your life, just kind of like soul searching and really trying to figure out like who you are, and then from there kind of like maybe to find like a new tribe or something. But that's it. That at this point is all intuitive. But I'm gonna close this reading out for you, Capricorn. I hope this reading helps in some way. Don't give up, Capricorn, right? I hope you do to find what you need to find in your journey, in your journey at this time. But keep in touch. I love you so much, Capricorn. If you found some cards that resonate with you in this reading, be sure to let me know in the comments. Be sure to give this video a like and subscribe, Capricorn, and hopefully I'll connect with you guys sometime in the near future.